Hi guys, I am Shahrukh with a review of Xiaomi Redmi Note 3 camera. The camera of Xiaomi Redmi Note 3 is equipped with 16 megapixel face detection autofocus with dual tone LED flash. Dual tone LED flash basically means the mixture of two colored flashlight to give decent photos even in low light conditions. Face detection autofocus is a hardware that gives fast focusing feature to the camera. You can see how fast is the camera focusing. Talking about the camera UI, the UI of the camera is very good, better than the stock Android AOSP camera app. If you swipe to the left, you will find some filters. If you swipe to the right, you will find some camera modes. On the main screen, you will get a flashlight on-off button, HDR on-off button, and a switching to rear and front camera button. Below is the button to open captured photos and a shutter button and a video recording button. Let's talk about the camera settings provided to have a better look at what this camera is capable of. The first setting you will get is save location info. If you turn this on, you will find that the location of your photos clicked will be tagged in your photos. So let me capture a photo and just see. You can see here the location of the photos have been tagged. You can also see the location on the map by clicking just the blue button, and it will see the exact location of where these photos have been clicked. But to perform this action correctly, you need to turn on the GPS by swiping top right and turning on the GPS from here. Okay, the next option is camera sounds. You can turn your camera sounds on or off by just enabling or disabling this button. It is just a sound of shutter button when you click the photos. The next is time watermark. If you turn this on and you click any photo, the watermark of the time and date will be added to your photos in the below. You see, the date and time of my photos clicked has been tagged to the photos, and you can see it is time anywhere. It is a good feature. And the next is show grid lines. If you are having trouble in clicking photos in frame, you can turn this feature on so it will show you two horizontal and two vertical grid lines, and you can actually use it to keep photos in frame. The next option is scan QR codes. If you turn this feature on or off, it will help you enabling and disabling the scanning of QR codes. You don't need any third-party app to scan QR codes. You just place the QR codes in your camera frame and it will automatically scan it. The next option is press and hold shutter button option, and it has been set to burst shoot, and another option is focus. Let's talk about them. The burst shoot is a mode where you can press and hold this shutter button to capture continuously photos. You can capture almost 100 photos continuously with it. The focusing and capturing is very fast, and there is no error in this. But if you set that option, press and hold shutter button to focus, and if you click and hold this, it won't click continuous photos. Instead, it will just focus, and when you leave it will capture a photo. So it is also a nice feature if you want focusing in your hands with capture button, but for me, burst shoot is best. The next is camera frame. Camera frame has two options, a standard 4:3 and full screen 16:9. A standard 4:3 captures your photos in full 16 megapixel camera, but in doing so, the top and the bottom will be left blank due to its 4:3 ratio, and your screen is 16:9 ratio. So to capture beautiful photos, you just put it to 16:9, but 16:9 ratio only captures photos in 12 megapixel. Also, it makes lesser file sizes in 16:9, and it also looks very beautiful. Some people says that always capture photos in standard 4:3 and later crop it. But let me tell you can't crop each and every photo due to your time limitations. So better keep it on full screen 16:9. The next option is picture quality, high, standard and low. If you keep on high, it gives the best quality of the photos, but it also results in bigger file sizes. Let me show you the file size of photo that I have clicked. It shows 6.03 MB. So in high, it almost takes 4 to 8 MB of spaces on each photo. So if you prefer low quality and low size photos, you can keep on a standard. So if you click photos in a standard mode, you will get almost 4 MB or 2 to 3 MB of, you can see 2.93 MB only instead of 6 point some MB. But I recommend you to keep it on high and standard only, not too low, because the low quality photos are useless. Those are not of great details. The next is face detection. Face detection options helps you in detecting faces of the person. You can just turn on the age and gender when beautify is on and detect a face, and it will show you the age and gender of the photos. Next is volume buttons function. Volume button function has three options: shutter, zoom and volume. If you press it on shutter, it will help you in clicking photos with your volume button. You can see when I press a volume button, it is clicking the photo. But you can turn this option to zoom, so you can zoom photos just by pressing and holding the volume button. It is a good feature if your second hand is not free, because zooming the photos needs you to swiping two fingers. The next option, volume buttons function has another option, that is volume. It is nothing, just to it is just controls the volume of your phone. So to switch off this function, you just need volume. I recommend it to put it on shutter so that you can keep your photos capturing by, if you want to capture selfie, you can easily capture it by volume buttons. And also, if you keep it on zoom, you can take advantage of the zoom function. The next is anti-banding. Anti-banding is nothing, just a simple flickering ratio of your camera. If you put it on 50 Hz or 60 Hz, it will result in little darker photos. So I recommend you to put it on auto or 60 Hz or 50 Hz. You can actually keep it anything, but I recommend it in keeping in auto. The next is auto exposure settings. Auto exposure settings gives you settings to control the lighting of the photos you are taking. If you keep it on frame average, the lighting will be average in each of the spots of the photos. And if you keep it on center weighted, the lighting of the photos will be much more focused on the center. And the spot metering is also just a small feature that it will focus on some of the spots of your photos. Better to keep it on center weighted so that the photos look beautiful, because if you click photos with center being focused more and having more light on center and darker around the edges, it will give you a better look of photos. The next option is contrast. As you know, contrast, it just controls the brightness and darker and the brighter side of the photos, and then the saturation and the sharpness. Saturation is also controls the almost brightness like feature. But then the sharpness can give you almost high to the lowest options, which leads you on how sharp you want the photos. But if you set the sharpness to the highest mode, let me tell you that the photo you will click on highest sharpness mode will look little, what I can say, little unnatural. So I recommend you to keep it on normal or high, as it gives best photos. And the last option in settings is the restore default settings. That is basically used to restore all the settings here to its default. Now talking about the video recording settings, there are some video recording settings too, like save location info, camera sounds, and another is image capture while recording. Image capture while recording helps you in capturing images while you are recording the video. Let me tell you, let me show you. If I record a then it gives a button here to capture the photo. You can actually capture while recording. So it is a nice feature. You can also turn this on or off if you don't need it, but I recommend it to turn it to keep it on. The next is video quality. Video quality is Full HD, HD or SD. Full HD means 1920 into 1080. HD means 1280 into 720, and SD means 720 into 480p resolution. The next is focus mode. Oh, let me tell you about some video quality. If you capture in Full HD, it will give you best video recording experience, but it also takes too much space. So you can capture it on HD, resulting in less smaller sizes in less smaller sizes of video recordings. And SD is also good, but I don't recommend it because the picture quality on SD lacks details. The next is focus mode. You can set focus mode to tap or continuous focus, that is CAF. What is this? Let me tell you. Let me show you. If I record any video and my focus had been set to tap mode, I can actually tap anywhere on the screen to focus the object or the person I am recording. But if I set focus mode to CAF, then the focus will be done automatically and nothing will happen if I touch anywhere on the screen. So I recommend you to keep this setting on tap mode so that you can focus if the video recording goes out of focus. Then another option is time-lapse interval. If you are creating time-lapse videos, that is almost likely a fast motion video, you can set the interval of time so each number of seconds increasing gives you much more faster videos. The next is volume button functions, you know already, and then anti-banding and restore default settings. Now let's talk about some of the camera filters. If you swipe left, you will find some camera filters like mono, vivid, yesteryear. Mono gives you black and white photos, then vivid, yesteryear, and these are all the filters likely to color. But I will talk about only the special features. Like the first is a sketch. If you want to capture photo like a sketch, you can actually use this. It is a very good option to capture amazingly sketch details photos. You can see I have captured the photo and it is almost likely a handmade sketch. The next special feature is the blur. If you want to take photos that blurry on every side and blurry on every side and just the object will not be blurry, you can set the blur according to your use and just capture the photo. It will give you good detailed photos which is blurry on every side but not on the object. Okay, the next is mosaic. Mosaic option helps you in keeping privacy on your photos. If you don't want to capture someone's photo or just wanna do a prank, you can use Mosaic to hide faces or hide some privacy of yours. Like, I want to hide the name of this phone, so I just capture it by setting. And now, see, Mosaic options blurs the effect of the photo. The next great option is the mirror. You can actually take mirror-like photos with this. You can see you can be very, very creative with this mirror option. And if you want to capture one hand with your another hand, you can use this mirror feature because both our hands are same, isn't it? Okay, so switching back to normal, I will now let you see some camera modes. Camera modes has some features like panorama. You already know panorama, just a quick view at panorama of this phone. Just switch on the panorama and click on the shutter button and begin the panning slowly. It will capture the photos in panorama. You can turn stop anytime or let it the slider to full. I will turn it to stop, and after some time the panorama will be created. You can see panorama, also known as the bigger photo. So it is a good feature. The next option is the timer. Timer has some options like audio, 3 second, 5 second, and 10 second. If you switch it to audio, you can actually capture photos by saying cheese or anything loudly. Like, let me give you an example. Cheese! You see, it took photos in 3 seconds after I said anything. Let me another. Hello! Yeah. The next is on the timer is 3 second, 5 second, and 10 second. You can set your seconds according to your use and just turn on the timer. Okay. The next option is manual. On the manual, you have some white balance features so that you can set along your color of the photos according to your need. I recommend to keep it in auto as it gives better. And the next one is ISO. It is for advanced users up to ISO 3200. I don't know much about it, but let me tell you, when I was cracking photo at night and I turned the ISO to 1600, it gave me better photos without flash. The next is gradient mode. It is an awesome new feature in Mi Xiaomi products. If you are unsure about that, if you place your camera horizontally or vertically and your photos being tilted, you can use this feature to keep photos straight or landscape mode. Just you need to capture photos in any direction and it will straighten up your photo automatically. See. Okay, I will another to I will another I will capture another photo. See, and now see the result. Oh, how straight, isn't it? Okay, the next option is beautify. Beautify mode is especially used to remove the wrinkles or pimples on the faces, but sometimes beautify mode gives you an unnatural feel to your photos. I recommend it if you use beautify, just keep it on low or medium, but not on high. High gives you a plasticity feel on your faces. The next is handheld twilight. If you are in very bright condition, handheld twilight will give you a better photo experience. If you capture photo, it will take some time and it will adjust the lightning condition of your photos. The next is scene mode. There are several scene modes like portrait, landscape, sports, night portrait, and etc. All these scene modes can be used if you are clicking photos. Like if you are clicking photos in a sports or someone is running, you want to click photo, just turn the scene mode on to a sports and it will capture better photos while moving. Sometimes it works, sometimes not, because this option is not very fast. The next, you can also turn this landscape mode so that you can have better photos of scenes, and night mode and night portrait and so on. The next is tilt shift, and it is also a great feature. If you want to blur all the sides of the photos except your object, you can use tilt shift mode. Just focus the where you want to capture photo and click, and all of the sides of the photos will be blurry except the object. It is also a great feature. Okay. The next one is fisheye mode. It is just a for fun purpose. You can actually turn someone into fat by using fisheye mode. So these are the camera modes available in Xiaomi Redmi Note 3 camera. The next option is the video recording option, and let us see some of the camera modes. The first option is time-lapse mode. Time-lapse mode is basically like a fast moving video recording. If you capture anything in time-lapse mode, it will move too fast around the. Let me show you just. Okay. See how fast the camera moved in time-lapse mode. The next option is the slow motion mode, and it is disabled. Slow motion mode is disabled because I have set the video quality mode to full HD. If you set the video quality mode to HD, the slow motion mode will automatically be enabled, and you can actually capture the videos in slow motion. Let me show you some example. I am capturing a slow motion video. Okay. See how slow is the video becomes. Okay. You can't turn on slow motion in full HD video because only 720p is supported. Now talking about the front camera. Front camera is also good. It has also some of the filters, or all of the filters, and it also captures decent photos. You can also turn on beautify and timer on front camera. Now there is one special feature of MIUI camera, the exposure settings in your hand. You can click on where you want to focus and then slide the circle to increase the exposure and slide left to decrease the exposure. See, it is a very good feature, and you can actually capture photos by just clicking here. So let me show you some of the camera photos I have taken. These are the photos I have taken with Xiaomi Redmi Note 3 camera. The details are very, very good, sharp and clear, and these are photos are captured at around 6 p.m. in the evening, so I have to turn on the flashlight because at night sometimes if you click photos, the details will not be very good without flashlight. See, these are all the photos clicked with flashlight. This one is without flashlight. I have used HDR in this. You can see some of the noises on the photo. So in the evening, I recommend you to turn on the flashlight, and also in the night. You can see the details of the photos. There are some dust, and it captured all the dust. Yeah. This one is without flashlight. I tried to capture, and it captured very, very good. But that time, okay. So now one thing. Does this camera support 4K recording? Because it is equipped with Qualcomm Snapdragon 650 processor, and on the official website it says that Qualcomm Snapdragon 650 is capable of recording 4K videos. So is it able to record 4K videos? Let me tell you, the stock camera app only gives you ability to capture it in full HD. If you want to capture 4K videos, yes, it is possible. You just need to download Google Camera app and open Google Camera app and turn on the video camera quality to USD 4K, and after that you can actually capture your videos in 4K mode. But let me tell you, the 4K video recording makes very bigger sizes of videos. Yeah, this is problem. Sometimes recording in 4K results you in bad quality greenish video. Let me try it again. Yeah, this time it worked. Yeah, but recording in 4K creates very bigger sizes of videos. Like, see the width of 2160 into 3840, and duration is only 4 seconds, but the file size is 20 MB. So I don't recommend you to use 4K until you want something very of great quality. And also, 4K videos are not supported in old laptops or computers, so better to use the full HD recording. So I am Shahrukh with a review of in-depth review of camera of Xiaomi Redmi Note 3. Thank you for watching.